A lot of what we see is horrible, but a lot of teens are just engaged in the family business.
That's it.
Ooh, that's a sermon in that right there. Alone, generational curses are real. Brothers and sisters, when you're living in poverty, and that's the reality of much of what we're dealing with, the realities are there are root causes to everything. The reason why anyone would steal your shoes is because they don't have any. Or the reason why they would rob you is because they want your money. And if they want your money, they don't have any. And so, brothers and sisters, at the root level, the root cause is those who do not have are going to get it. Some by any means necessary. Gonna get it by any means necessary. Now, the rest of us, we want to get it the honest way. You hungry, everybody has to eat, but you go to school, you go get a job, you earn some money, and you go to the grocery store and you buy it. Or you don't go to school, but you get a job and you figure it out and you eat. Others don't have that same sense. Some are so desperate that they'll do whatever is necessary. Michael, sin doesn't pay well. The wages is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. How much does a gift cost? Nothing, because it's free. Oh, I wish I had some witnesses in here this morning. When somebody gives you a gift, it's free. You didn't pay for it, but somebody paid the price, and Jesus paid the price for you. If there's anybody in here who's sanctified and saved right now, can we just testify that Jesus Christ has been too good to us? Jesus has been better to us than we've been to ourselves. Jesus saved your soul when you were sinking deep in sin. He didn't have to do it, but he did it anyway. Why? Because he loved us. Ain't no more rules to the game. Ain't no more rules. For those of y'all who are kind of, you holy and you don't know what I'm talking about, the rest of us know that there used to be rules to the game. Amen. There used to be rules in the street. There used to be a code on the street. Ain't no more code. Even crime was organized. It's no longer organized. It's every click and crew for themselves. There's no more gangy. See, this is the mistake people make. And this is why I just did not like the comment that I won't even call him a brother. He wasn't my brother. When he was sitting at the table with Donald Trump and said, I talked to the top gang thugs, the top leaders. What? First of all, I would never refer to my brothers and sisters as top gang thugs.
That's it.
First of all. Second of all, ain't no leaders. Everybody's for themselves. There are no rules. I'll rat you out before you rat me out. Ain't no rules. The only one rule that is a dangerous rule is those that know won't say. And those who say don't really know. But there is a code of silence. The reason why it's dangerous, the code of silence for us, it's dangerous because if you are a victim, you fear retaliation.
Yep.
So we don't speak, we don't say, we don't snitch on anybody. There's a no snitching rule on the streets. That's live and well in effect. You're also in danger because police sometimes you don't feel like they help you or protect you. So I do understand the no snitching rule, but on the streets, there are no rules to the game. So the point I'm making is this. So you're a drug dealer, you make $52,000 a year, you make $1,000 a week, standing on a corner, risking your life for really what amounts to chump change. But nowadays, drug dealers are getting robbed.
Yep.
You ain't the toughest kid on the block now.
Because
when people know you're making money, you the man with all the money, you the homegirl with all the money, we gonna wait and plot on you to rob you. Yep. So nobody's safe. And to make sure you're dead, we coming to the funeral. We don't care. Ain't no respect. Don't nobody respect no funeral. We're coming to the funeral. As Biggie said, make sure all the singing and flower bringing is real. So brothers and sisters, these are the times in which we live. And I just want us to make sure that as adults, we don't have a naive perspective of what our young people are dealing with. You know what your teenagers are thinking about? I know you don't want to hear it. You're thinking about sex.
Come on,
because guess what?
Make it
plain. That's what you're thinking about too. And people kill me in church. We act like in church. Somehow we're human in the world, but when we get to church, the humanness comes off, and now we're... No! You're a human being. That's not... Nobody wants to talk about sex in church either, but that's how we all got here. Everybody got here that way. There was no way around it. That's how you got here. That's what they're thinking about. I know that's what they're thinking about. They won't tell you. That's why they try to switch you. They get on Facebook, now you got on there, now they got to get off. They got on Instagram, you got on there, now they got to get off. There are social media mediums that I don't even know about yet.
Yeah.
When a teen said, Pastor, you need to be on Snapchat. This was months ago. I said, what's that? You just take a picture and it lasts for a few seconds and then it disappears. I said, well, why do I want it to disappear? Now I understand. I get it now. They don't want you to see what they just posted. But brothers and sisters, here's the reality. As adults, we really have to be in tune with our young people.
That's it.
It's best to know what they're doing. It's best to know their friends. It's best to know their teacher. It's best to know who they're hanging with than to not. And so when we look at the life of Jesus, Jesus was not old. He was 30 when he began his ministry. That means he was young. And his name, Jesus Christ, his name means anointed one. Jesus, Savior, Christ, anointed one. He is our Messiah. He was the one anointed to save us from sin and death. And brothers and sisters, what I want you to know, especially our young people, you are anointed. If you're a child of God, you are anointed.
Come on.
God anointed means God has placed a mark on you. You have been marked for greatness. You have been marked for life. Amen. You have been anointed. God has placed his hand on you and his presence inside of you so he can use you in a mighty way. And here's how you know you're anointed. Here's one indicator that you know you've been chosen, because the devil tried to get to you early. The devil tried to get to you early. Most of us as adults, I'm 46, whatever your age is, 56, 76, 86, whatever your age as an adult, the devil tried to get to you early. The devil tried to get to each and every one of us probably within the first 5 years of our lives. If not the first five, the first 10, those are the formative years. Trying to tear you down early. Whatever your situation is, whatever it is, God chose you. And then the devil tried to stop you. But oh, here's the testimony of the anointed.
Come on.
Whatever the devil tried to do to stop you, God used it to bless you. God used it for your good. And the devil meant it for your bad. The devil meant it for your destruction. But God took what the devil tried to do to destroy you, and he developed you. See, in this life, you've got to take your anointing, and when you go through a test, the only thing that will carry you through is the Word of God. It's the Word. Everything you learn in church, when you go off to school, take the Word with you. David said, "Thy Word have I hid in my heart." Amen. You got to take the Word with you, because no matter what you go through, at least this Word will be in you, and it will get you through it. It'll get you through it. And I party all the time. Amen. I can't help it. I party.
It's real.
I study, but I party.
Yeah, it's real.
When I went to the party, and being an Omega, the party don't start till the Q's get there anyway. Whenever the party start when the Q's get in the house. Amen. No offense, Brother Myers. I know that. But I'm just saying, I enjoyed my college life. But I didn't care what was going on Saturday night. Hangover or not, I went to church.
That's it. That's right.
And I didn't go to church because I had to.
That's it.
Because I was on campus. My mama wasn't there. Right. Nobody was there to tell me to get up and go to church. I did it because I went to church so young, and I went to church every Sunday when I was young, so that when I went off to college, I wasn't just going to abandon Jesus just because I learned that parties existed, just because I learned that alcohol, I wish I had a witness, just because I learned that alcohol existed. No, I know better than that. I got Jesus. Jesus.
That's it.
And if I'm gonna dance hard at the party, I ain't gonna forget about praising my Jesus. We do so well in the world, but when it comes to the church, we act like we ain't forgot. Now you can't dance, now you can't shout, now you can't praise. You used to do it at the club. I dare you to give Jesus a shout. I dare you to give Jesus a dance. How dare you go to the club? How dare you go to the party and come up in here and act all stupid like you can't give Jesus some praise? Somebody prayed to you. You gotta be willing.